It's the final match from Fukuoka at this year's FIVB Men's Volleyball World Cup, and it features the host Japan going up against the South Americans from Argentina here at the Marine Mesa. Yes, it's the last day on match day five here at the FIVB Volleyball World Cup for men. As you can see, the front runners are setting a hot pace here with Brazil, USA, Poland and Russia starting to edge away from the pack. But Japan or Argentina can join Russia on three wins and two defeats from their first round of matches if they can sign off here in style. Well, they both had their ups and downs. The biggest up for Argentina was their start when they knocked off the United States in five sets. Well, it really was a stunning result. That sent a shockwave around the competition, that is for sure. But they've not really been able to build on that, losing in five to Italy and then really fading away pretty badly against Argentina, losing that one in four sets. And against a very, very motivated and determined Japan, it's going to be tough for Marcelo Mendes to get his men over the line. There will be some score presentation as well. We expect to see some of that. Yesterday, Japan rested a lot of their frontline players as they went up against the United States. They'll come back fresh. Argentina have had a heavy rotation for their starters. Not an awful lot coming off the bench. You wonder if Marcelo Mendes might have one or two leggy players in his squad. They will travel. Everybody goes on the road to Hiroshima tomorrow, and there's a rest day after that. After the official introduction of our two match referees.
The second referee is Mr. Nassam Jama from Egypt.
これより両国国歌の演奏を行います。ご来場の皆様はご起立、ご打つぼの上、ビジョンの国旗にご注目ください。
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Argentina. And now, the national anthem of Japan.
This is the Argentina squad. It's been sent over to Japan by Marcelo Mendes. Left a lot of his big players at home, the likes of Facundo Conte and Sebastian Solé and Luciano De Checo. They're not here. But Japan, of course, everybody is here. And Yuji Nishida, the young teenager, number 11, was given a night off yesterday. So he comes back into the squad fully rested. Well, it'll be interesting to see exactly what happens here, and which one of these two teams can finish on a high. Both of them pretty well beaten yesterday. Started off with a bang, beating Italy. It was a bit of a surprise. And they went down in straight sets to Poland and the United States. The struggling group out of the six teams that have been in for the World Cup. Can Japan register a third victory? Off a place as the backup setter. Jan Martinez has been as solid a campaigner as they've had, and that's interesting. A start for young Luciano Polonsky, who's come off the bench a couple of times. The 20-year-old look good. As Agustin Losser, coming up to his 22nd birthday, Bruno Lima comes out, and a start also for Joaquin Gallego. Marcelo Mendes has sprung a couple of surprises here. There's no Martin Ramos, there's no Ezequiel Palacios, but Gallego and Polonsky come in. We didn't see Matsuya Fukuzawa yesterday. He's rested. The veteran comes back fully refreshed. Huge part of the offense. Nishida, 19 years old, future superstar, already a superstar here. Masahiro Sakita comes back as setter. Yuki Ishikawa, the big hitter, comes in as well. Kentaro Takahashi keeps his place from yesterday. And Taishi Onodera comes back in. Tomohiro Yamamoto taking the job of libero. So Yuichi Nakagaichi, a good player in his day back in the 90s, brings all the big stars back and keeps Kentaro Takahashi in the starting lineup. We expected the return of Akihiro Yamauchi there, but an impressive performance from Takahashi yesterday. We've seen him keep his place. It is, as always, best of five sets. First to 25 wins the set, accompanied by 2 points. As ever, the pace is rocking. Silence. It's almost like a tennis or a snooker arena in here when play begins. Takahashi or Fukuzawa rather. This is getting underway with a soft little dink serve. The two real big hitters, Yuki Nishida and Yuki Ishikawa, will have to be the engine here. There is plenty of support. Fukuzawa certainly provides plenty of that, but Japan want to get the win here. Nishida and Ishikawa will have to have huge contributions. Now, so it's there for the taking. Danani deals with that one. Sent on its way, so Peter's kept it alive though. Ishikawa will swing at that. Martinez picked it up. And a little dip. Oh, that's not going to work. Oh, a good chance of putting this away. Back it comes. Still it goes on though. Nishida will try one from deep. Martinez solid in the backcourt again. It's an unbelievable point. Japan to gain. Ishikawa comes in with the stop block. And Argentina will be asking themselves, how did we not win this point? Wind the clock back 30 seconds or so. And Masahiro Sakino was getting a second touch from right in front of the audience. They were taking cover in the front row. Shouldn't be winning points from there, but Argentina never saw a kill opportunity. Fukuzawa's little dicky-doo serves come to an end. He'll be very happy with the start inside of made here. Sanchez has always got an ace or two. Usually, Japan get blocked out of matches. They always lose the block battle. And a couple of early successes here. Yuji Ishikawa against Bruno Lima. Now that'll raise an eyebrow. On the sidelines for Argentina, two blocks against Lima already. That's a worry. Uh-huh. There are floats on the way. Side out. Let's see how Luciano Polonsky enjoys the responsibility of getting a start. He's come off the bench, the 20-year-old, and looked good. Confident young player. Self-belief. Yeah, not a great save. But, you're asking Yuji Nishida to try and get winners from there. There is a high risk that you're going to get a block or you're just going to get nothing but nylon. And I think this was netcourt all the way. Yeah, that didn't come back. That's Argentina. Back on track. Service reception, absolutely crucial. Ishikawa, will he go for the big power serve? Very well taken. Ooh, and reliable a hitter as they have Argentina, and Ian Martinez has just sent that cross for too long. Beautiful take. It was Polonsky back there who picked this up. Couldn't have done it much better. Been on the receiving end of a couple of blocks. Let's see what he can do on serve as he goes. Well, he's had a very shaky start. Japan will be very, very happy if Bruno Lima does not get going. Because if he does, he will make a big contribution. Here's Kentaro Takahashi at 7-5. Really does take the ball too nicely. One of these young players being given a run out here. Taking over from the veteran Martin Ramos. Well, there will be the first technical timeout is triggered by the leading team reaching 8 points. Martinez looking to delay that here. So. Yeah!
だ。
特に石川がフロントで
攻めたら。はい、プレー。はい、やっとスコアを打つ。
もう少し正確に。
はい、ボール。
仕掛けたを成功したからね。オッケー。この次だよ、次。で、まだクイック使ってきてるから。
I keep serve. I can change.
You have also been doing this for the whole line.
Frenchman is the attention to detail coach for Japan. Chance for him to special observations. A wobbler there from Shida. Back from Martinez, going back to what he does so well. Very strong defensive player, Martinez, we've seen that, but you've got to be an all-rounder at this level. Got to be able to do a bit of everything, and Martinez, a very confident and capable hitter as well. The front running, not good chasing. Mixing up his serves for Kozawa. Wronski taking a touch on the way through there for the side out. Needed that to settle himself down. Sanchez then. Yeah. reaction was that that took a touch. That was pretty quick. Oh no, it's in or out is what they're calling. That's Luka's just hit another one. Too long. He's not settled at all. Marcelo Mendes has to slow this one down.
El paso y peguémosle a la bola. Estamos porque si no nos defienden y vuelve la bola, la tiramos. Pero más que defendernos, la tiramos afuera. Todas bolas fuera nuestras. Vamos a empezar a atacar nosotros.
Contacto reset,
players have started this match. They're going to be warming up for the bullpen sooner rather than later. Any soft serves that come in, there's every chance that Los Air is going to be charged with the task of putting those to bed. Side out, essential. Not out of this yet, Argentina, but now chasing 3 points. Still with time to pull it back, but they're not firing on all cylinders yet. This is a good serve, and I didn't miss my match. One area of his game he really hasn't worked on over the last year or so, Agustin Lasser. That was not much of a weapon at all in Bulgaria in the World Championship. It's a weapon here. Ishikawa brings a weapon. He's done very, very well to get that back. Lovely kill straight down the gut, but that was all on the quality of the serve. On another day, that could have been an ace. So we approach the second technical timeout, which will happen if there's a big ace here. Argentina needed it. Bruno Lima needed it as well. Blocked out a couple of times early. Couple of miscues. Absolutely drilled that one. So, Argentina will hope that's got Lima's engine started here. Long serve will send Japan to the second technical timeout. With a very healthy lead. Promising start this for the hosts.
Right now they don't spike quick here. Only spike the quick is over the spike. S6, remember for the K2. K2, you stay front. Because this guy, opposite spike here, and the quicker like this, so they can stay forward.
Thank you.
can Argentina get themselves back into this first set? Takahashi. Sends one along. Too long. Yeah, Martinez. We'll step up next. Last take. Now then, watch out. Yuji Nishida's at the service line. Very happy to see that happen. Sakita check out. Big hitter himself at nicely played, Sanchez. That was not a great. Well, he looked stunned. I thought he'd dinked that over perfectly, but he's obviously a net violation here. Or has it gone out? That's gone out. Oh, he has to have that. Really has locked the door. Surely. Bruno Lima put some serious hot sauce. That had some jalapeno sauce on it, that one. Get a taste of this and burn your mouth. Watch out. Players in and out. And ever since Otaka was given a chance to play against the United States. Bandera did not make the most of that service opportunity, but nevertheless, Japan are very comfortable here in this first set.
Dale,
A last chance then for Marcelo Mendes to try and come up with something that will change the narrative here in this first set. I think realistically he'll know there's not much chance of that. Issei Otake, big serve. Gotta clear the net. I think that'll be Otake's little cameo done. So he's will come back in then. So Argentina look to try and do something about the 5 points they need on serve. To get back on level terms. From Tatsuya Fukuzawa. Again, service reception, absolutely sublime. The pipe attack comes in, they fake to the inside middle. Fukuzawa basically had a clear run to the corner. This to Ben. Now Lima is up next to serve, and Lima is a dangerous server. We haven't seen it yet from him. And he decides just to take plenty off this one. They'll come back. Finally, finally, Argentina coming up with a bit of D here. With the soft stuff. Outside goes Machida. Come on, wouldn't they? Literally could go anywhere. A switch up. We'll see Hemman Johansson and Matias Dorado come in. For Sanchez and Lima. It's Marcelo Mendes saying we've got to get a block here. Got to get a block point. Excitement as Masahiro Yanagida, the captain, comes in as a pinch hitting server. Very dynamic player. Another one of these full-blooded Japanese hitters. Themselves up. That was not a good first set for them at all. the numbers, the big one is the battle of the blocks. If Argentina can't win that, they're going to be in for a long night. Ishikawa with a couple of early ones really setting the tone. Now Ace is there. It's a bit of a surprise considering both these teams have got some very, very big servers. And Japan winning the battle of the attack hits, 12-9. Solid start. Once they've got their lead, they never look like losing it. So, first blood Japan, the FIVB president is here once again. It's always a pleasure to see him here. He absolutely loves his time in Japan. And I appreciate his support for volleyball in Japan as well. Really enjoying the experience. Great start there for Japan, but that's all it is. Argentina made a similar start against Italy. They took the first two sets, took them comfortably, ended up losing in five. It's great to look good in that first set. Of course it is. It gives you something to build on. But some Argentinians experienced enough, even though a lot of them are young, experienced enough to know that there's a lot of play still left in this one. And here's a big server coming off the bench right here. Palacios, a pace specialist. That's a beauty. Look at what's happened there. He's gone back on first touch. Oh, no, no, no. Wonderful defensive work. Really good stuff that from Japan. Was the key. It's Lima denied again by Ishikawa. Zoning Lima at the moment, isn't he? Yeah, no, don't bring her here. Wobbled over the net, didn't it? Sharper early here. Serb to deal with. They've certainly come out with their big servers in the rotation. Palacios followed by Los Serbs. Lima to come. Chip on their shoulder, those two, with a point to prove. There we go. This could get very interesting attack here. Oh, how's he conjured that one up? Well, Ishikawa with the hoist and hope. Lovely control pick there from Nishida. That was nice. And Argentina looking a lot more solid here. They're already wobbling a little bit this early in the first set. Martinez only chance to run that, you know. Lima's going to have a tough one here. The set to Sakita, goes for second touch, didn't work. Lima has to another tough one and gets blocked. Now that's not the fault of Bruno Lima. Probably feeling sorry for himself anyway, the blocks that's come back on him. It's not Ishikawa again, surely. Tough to see from that angle, it definitely wasn't Ishikawa, it's Onodera this time. That's the fourth time Bruno Lima's been blocked, but that, not all his fault. Far from it. Tough to take a winner on from there. So Yoshida will stay there. Martinez gets under that one nicely. Sanchez, crafty server. There's another one that's caused a problem. No play there available. Oh, no, 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 no. His cross court puts Argentina ahead here. It's no accident that Ezequiel Palacios has come off the bench, wreaking a bit of havoc here. Once you get one hitter up and running, it opens up opportunities elsewhere on the court. Promising this for Argentina. You have to just stay with it. We've got a problem to deal with here as Lima goes. He must be thinking, what have I done? What on earth have I done? Five times Bruno Lima has been blocked. Oliveira twice in this set. Yeah, Lima has to check out. Polonsky will come back in. He just needs a breather, Lima. That's all it'll be. Lima's far too good a player to be yanked out of this match, you would think. Well, it's Polonsky with a chance to get himself back up to speed here. Not the most challenging of serves. It's Argentina 8-7.
Armando a Palacio, ¿sí? Ahí acelerar y cortar la bola, ¿sí? Porque en cuanto dejamos caer el brazo, hizo la bien y la amortigua en toda la bola. En cuanto le sacamos a Fukuzawa delantero, juega del medio para atrás, juega del medio para atrás mucho. Vamos, vamos a seguir atrás.
So well. Had seen it, so he sent it down the line where there was nobody home. That was clever. If he'd gone cross court, Palacios would have had that. Yamamoto there to deny. Palacios, and then they get the put away at the back. with the hit. Palacios, no way he was picking up this cross court. Nishikawa, wonderfully creative. The heat here, and Argentina have to respond to this. First, they've got to get Ishikawa. Right there. Here's Martinez. Still another chance. How have they won that? How on earth have they done that? That was unpromising to say the least. Fukuzawa denied. That's brilliant rescue work. But really, the block had so long to set. Fukuzawa shouldn't have had any chance here against Ramos. Well, he somehow found a way through. At the second time of asking, that was a big chance for Argentina, and they couldn't take it. Really strong this. He's very happy now his team's playing here. Soft serve from Ramos. Killer serve. Court, of course. So 14-12, they're looking for a bit more. Shooters serve, but not getting it there. Got their lead. Can they build on it? Polanski doesn't get a winner. Sakita will bring it back. There's no play there available. Is it just a deep push? Polanski will have another go. This time he does get through. That's a missed opportunity. Asensio, so close. That's going to get reviewed, it was so close. Every time Ezequiel Palacios serves, there is danger. Now, have they got away with this, Japan? Just.
When they come, a quick. As well, if you call commit, they don't call. エクイックです。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイック。エクイ
And quick, see fast reaction.
But if we commit, you have to go to one.
Commit to the two.
Really impromptu.
Okay.
Set where they want it. Well, it's not going to take much for this one to turn around. They keep coming up with unexpected block points here. Yeah, that was Sakita taking Martinez out. We're getting block points off Sakita. Things are going your way. This set is now going Japan's way. Argentina need side out right now. On the Onodera serve, puts a lot of movement on his serves. That's well won. That was close. Well, so I said that wasn't. That's exactly what I was aiming for. It looked a little bit closer than it needed to be, but it's so comfortable, isn't it? Yeah. No fuss. This is just inspired. Absolutely brilliant.
La pasa che attacca se riusciamo. Se non empuja, la pasa. Tenemos que estar atentos a esos detalles. Principalmente de acá, tenemos levantado adelante. Que pasa la manito, tenemos que coger esa cosa. Pasa por ahí principalmente.
Okay.
Gone. It's Akita. And so Argentina desperate. They get themselves back into this. Martinez. Oh, my goodness. This is very, very worrying to Marcelo Mendes. He's going to freshen things up. Nicolas Lazo will come in. Martinez just takes a breather off that miss. There's no pulling this back. Sit back down again, and Lima recharged and refreshed. It's certainly not all been his fault. You know, he's just had one of those days when the blockers in front of him are reading him so well. One of those being Ishikawa, who's serving here. Well, that's just what he needed. You come off the bench and you're asked to swing, and you've had so many blocks against you. Your heart's going to be in your mouth. But he gets the win this time, drilled it straight at Fukuzawa. That wasn't coming. As they search for 4 points in a hurry here. There's a chance of one there. That's a beauty. He is a big server, as we can see. A couple of points can change everything. Yuichi Nakagaichi senses danger. Just missed. Oh, I think just about everybody in this arena breathes a sigh of relief. Yanagida will come in. Jordan for his serve. They're nearly over the line here, Japan. But Argentina, not showing a bit of grit here, give themselves just an outside chance. If Argentina can side out here, they look to keep the pressure on. Indeed, it's the first order of business. Really well. Since he then gets clocked out of it. Oh my goodness, they've come up with another block point. That was Taiji Onodera there, the big man. Oh, Palacios ripped it. Nishida alongside Onodera, but I think that's the big middle. I'll take that one. And that surely is the end of that.
Podemos atacar fuerte esa bola. Estamos, falta jugar un poquito más, en el saque jugar un poco más, los que le pegan jugar un poco más, nosotros mantenemos el equilibrio en el flotado. Vamos a buscarla en cada bola que hacemos, en cada reacción que hacemos, cada bola.
The story of this match has been the blocking. Nishikawa and Onodera leading the way, three each now for those two, but Fukuzawa and even Sakita chipping in. Ramos has got one. And there was a putback rather than a block earlier. I think it came from Gallego, but they have dominated on blocks, Japan, in this match. Dominating on the scoreboard as well. 2 points from a two-set lead here. Yanagida nets. In an ideal world, you don't want Martin Ramos coming up to serve. He's not one of the big hitters, but one of the time. Not a lot. Onodera has made a mess of that. And another block. Onodera gets under that. Gets under that to Nishida. One left the block away. And that is set point. That is probably last chance, Argentina. Otake will join the party. That set point. It'll be Nishida, one of the many whipping big servers to try and serve it out here. Japan on the brink of a two-set lead. Beautifully taken by Lazo. And then Vizios, picked off by Yamamoto. Far side it goes, and that's a winner off the block. Rocking and rolling, Tatsuya Fukuzawa takes up Argentinian fingertip on the way through. It's another set for Japan. Last night, USA coach John Spurrier said Argentina may be the most improved team in world volleyball year on year. They are looking really good here against an Argentina squad ranked four places above them. Two sets in the bank, and they've won them on merit as well. Oh, a wry smile there from Mendes. the blocks. That's the story of this match. Nothing else really matters. Everything else is a detail. The story of this match, pure and simple. Japan blocking the life out of Argentina. If that carries on, they'll win this in three. They've got to find an antidote here. Argentina. Two five setters already. They're in for the World Cup, winning one of them against the United States after almost blowing a two-set lead, and then blowing a two-set lead against Italy. Here, they're hoping for a chance at another five-setter. Set about to start. Picked off. Yeah, facing a three-man block. The block held. That's another goal. That's good enough. He's hit it so well. Double figures has been a constant nuisance. Argentina just cannot close him down. Fukuzawa then will stay on. Looking to make a strong start here in this third set. And a disastrous take from Palacios. The putback was there easy. Well, the overpass, just not what they needed at all. And Ishikawa was there to gobble it up. Japan out the blocks early here. Argentina just rocking here. Marcelo Mendes is toying with the prospect of more changes. Boy, does he need an ace here from Ezequiel Palacios. This whole match, Losser. Oh, he needs one. Was he getting on there? Ishikawa continues just to keep chipping away. Ishikawa and Yoshida might be the headline grabbers. His contribution always significant. So Japan jumping out early. Sakita. Not a big server, but a creative server. Goes for a big one. It's a bit of a surprise. Oh, he just got this is good hitting from Nicholas Lazo on the edge. Bearing in mind that Japan is so good at bringing things back. That's two then. We'll never get anything on Lazo. Two out of two for him. Keeps Argentina. Now this is a big moment. Japan have the lead and they have Ishikawa on serve. Argentina needs side out. Right under that Palacios. They're finding a reliable source of points now, Argentina. Nicholas Lazo, who's come up with three in this third set. Nearly got himself blocked out of it, but the net cord was helpful. Let's see what he can do with serve, he's big. Couldn't get out of the net cord, could he? Well, there's signs of encouragement here from Mendes. Well, when you're chasing, even this early, you've got to side out. He's picked that up beautifully. Captain enjoyed that one. So he will now go back. They look for a point on serve. Ramos would be an unlikely source of a point on serve. Well, you never know. And he's not one of their power servers, Ramos. Oh my goodness me, complete mess made of that. Well, they do get a point on the Ramos serve. And there won't be a challenge there because whoever that did touch will have just said no. That got me. Don't challenge. Oh, mess made of service reception. And they pay for that. That's a lot better. That's a big miss. Now, that's two errors back to back here from Japan. Both unforced as well. So Ramos will go again. Here from Japan. focus or they think the job's done. That's three errors in a row.
La agarra en otro punto.
Now Argentina have a lead from 10. Thomas Elevent is, we can't believe it. Meanwhile, Philippe Lahm and Yuichi Nakagaichi got some work to do on the other side.
Pasa por ahí, señores. Vamos a sacarlo hasta abrir el bloqueo de nuevo. Vamos a sacarlo ahora.
This one over. Fukuzawa. I'm not quite sure what Fukuzawa is going to give us on serve. Yeah. Oh, a lot there. I'll say they're absolutely buried. Yeah, they've been given a lifeline here, Argentina. They really have. Well, Lacer has been knocking those back all match long. No reason for that to stop now. guess he's due an ace. Seen too many aces in this match. One delivered by Nicolas Lazo at the back end of that second set. We've seen a lot of blocks, most of them from Japan. Not seen any in this set. Picked off. He's got a job to do here. Three of them stacked up to take him out at the net. And he saw the move in the backcourt as well and just pushed it deep. This is absolutely beautiful. Absolutely perfect from Ishikawa. Didn't take that block on. That block would have buried him. 6-1 then. Japan trying to push themselves back in to pole position here. Argentina needing to side out to their level. Nice take from Lazo. Really good take. Lazo gets that touch and misses. Oh, that's a bonus one. Now Lazo's been hitting so well. He took on that tight angle again. When these work, they're unplayable. Well, that has just failed to catch the sideline, and Marcelo Mendes has to call a timeout. Argentina chasing again. Been here before.
Recepción, partamos de nuevo. Vamos a buscarlo nuevamente. Sí, la recepción. Son dos o tres errores consecutivos que cometimos. Sí, tratemos de regularizarnos. Presiona con el saque, podemos resolver tranquilamente por la punta. ¿Sí? Dejemos la centralizada si nos presionamos con el saque. Rotemos, rotemos y le podemos el saque de nuevo. Dale, dale, dale.
It's a good response to falling behind, isn't it? Philippe Blay just turned the screws back up on the machine, I think.
Should be not good in the
second. All that's needed.
Okay?
Easy to get away with it, but at world level, you switch off like Japan did for 3 points in a row. That can cost you a set. Here, they're back on track. They've restored their lead, and Argentina being forced to chase once again, and the first order of business, side out. We'll need a response off that timeout, Argentina. Sikita serving, three of them going for it. There for Lazo, there's a good chance for Ishikawa. Goes for a mid-court dink, and that's good enough. They want that looked at, Argentina. Floor touch is what they'll be questioning. That's a tough call. That's tough to see on that replay. And the tough part of these is the player can get the fingers under the ball, but part of the ball can also touch the floor. You can have simultaneous. I think it was Danani trying to get under that, the libero, if he's got it all. Hit the floor, but there is hand under there as well. That's tough, so close for Argentina. It was worth a call. There is floor there, clearly. Now the gap grows again, a little bit wider. What an opportunity for Japan here. So there, nice ball. This is the worst possible response to that timeout. You lose 2 points in a row. Now the set's getting away. Looked like he'd nailed that perfectly there, Lazo, but it just kept on floating and floating and floating. And Takahashi's eyes got really big as it came over the net. That was an easy kill. There is the flight of the serve there. Beautiful, wasn't he? And Argentina were able to react. Cross-court, but they're hanging on here. They had a lead, albeit a narrow one. Here, they're chasing 3 points on serve. As we approach the second technical timeout, Lima is not going for the big serves anymore. And he serves as safe as that. He's asking for trouble. Takahashi with the put away off the inside set. Now we are in the second technical timeout. And that was just too easy. All he had to do was swing. Man, nearly there. Send this one back. They want to block. And it's the Lazo serve as well that makes the play. Got a chance. It's a chance. But they take it. There's one claw back. Lassius. Quiet recently. Yeah. Lazo. First touch. Oh, big error there from Fukuzawa. An error forced by the quality of the serve, and Ramos has got his game face on, hasn't he? And Philippe Blaine says, you know what? We need to do this again. It's Blaine or Nakagaichi, but everybody would have been pressing the timeout button there. And in danger of blowing this.
Nice line of burn of goal, you are right. You can take it in. He focus, he turns up this passion. With also with mine. That you are, Madame Jenny. All together, like a team, come on.
Wow, what a difference maker. points in a row on the Lazo serve. Suddenly we're all level again. Last thing you need off a side out. The other team to serve up an ace. So we'll look for more. Lazo's in the backcourt, they've got a chance here. Palacios, that's gone. Suddenly, this third set has a very different look to it. Now, Japan are chasing. Well, they've got to change things up. Naoya Takano will come in. Fukuzawa, who's had nightmares through the Lazo serve. Taken out of the firing line, probably with the benefit of hindsight, should have done that at the timeout. Yeah. What a crisis here for Japan. We're level, but Japan have a team chasing. That 3-point lead, they could have just played side out all the way to the winning line. Can't do that anymore. They're doing the chasing. Takahashi delivers with an ace. Another twist. Danani, who's a pretty good service receiver, just couldn't handle that one. Well, at least they've made Argentina play the chasing game again with that ace. Wouldn't he love to find another one? Takahashi. Lines it up. Mirror beats up, I guess, as well. He's done his job. Now, the last time Martin Ramos came up to serve, everybody's thinking, no danger, no problem. 3 points later. Block again, and that's exactly why Herman Johansson is in there. That's what he's there for. Send it back. That's Takano just off the bench. Getting wiped out there. Now Japan are chasing. And another point on server block. In control of this set. In the service line, it's Yujin Ishida. Argentina need inside out here. There's the chasing again. Danani handled that absolutely. Oh, that's been kept alive. The back attack, no, sent back. They'll just have to contain here. Argentina playing really high level stuff now. Where's that going to go? It's going to go and go and go. Palacios gets a winner. That's a big point for Argentina. Well, that's as well as they play defense. And then they transition. And a big swing from Palacios. They're not going anywhere, are they, Argentina? They want a fourth set. They want a fifth set. We've seen the best of them now. Sanchez. She does! Overplayed that. This set might just have gone. Sanchez got back. Argentina have got this set. Not coming back from this.
Second guy, all the transition. They finish left, and he hits on the block, and the ball is
全部レフトサイドから打って、ね、レフトの上から来てるから、その後ろのディフェンスでしっかりと。何殺した
はい、come on。はい、come 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 on。
Close to taking this into a fourth set for Zara. The sneak on Palace has got it. Hopefully been blocked. That side out should surely be enough then for Argentina. Even if they side out, Donna Vera due up next in the rotation. It's not a devastating server. This man is. Palacios looking for an ace that will surely see. Yeah! Now, they bring a pinch hitter in here. No, they don't. They will keep Amadora in the rotation. They need 2 points very, very quickly on serve. Not the best of takes. Lazo's got work to do. They're chasing this one. It's just voiced and hope from Benani. Should be a winner for Japan, but they're on the pressure. Brilliant, brilliant from Palacios. Lazo finishes it. That's all about Palacios and what he did in the backcourt there. That right there has just secured the set for Argentina. There is no coming back from this for Japan. Server. An ace here would make life interesting. Palacios has done brilliantly. Oh, look at this! Oh, Ramos had the set in his hand and he's missed it. My goodness me. No point challenging that. That's gone. He's not challenging it. Marcelo Mendes is calling a desperately needed timeout. Those nerves will be jangling here.
Palacio por 4 que se va. Estamos, está malo para él, salimos por ahí. Venga con usted, vamos.
Go, go, go.
Argentina wrap it up, take it into a fourth set. And Japan level this third set. Make them sweat. Issei Otake has got to come up with a good one. If it's safe, it's coming back. But when you put pressure on, you run the risk of the net serve or the long serve. And Otake finds something special here. Huge moment in this match. Lazo's got it though. Lazo will look for the first across there. Kept alive. Lazo again doesn't really have much of a play here. Japan can level this. Serving, it has to be said. Otake has certainly done his part, but all that does is extend this set past 25 points because you have to win by two clear points. Argentina still have a chance with side out to beat the team that's putting the pressure on. And Japan tip the scales in their favour. Music brilliantly picked up by Lazo. Absolutely no doubt at all what he's going to do with that. That set point in Argentina. But Otake can check out. Job done. Sakita will come back in. But this is still a big moment. Just got a soft one. Well, they've got a chance here. Here we go. Lima is wiped out on set point. My goodness me. They were there together. Yoshida, I think, was claiming it. Takahashi was right alongside him, and there was no way through. Another block against Bruno Lima, who's had a nightmare against these Japanese blockers, but still Argentina can side out and serve for the set. And Japan change it up here. Another good serve, beautifully taken again. Lazo in one of his brilliant cross-court kills. Really are showing some resolve here. Can they get the job done? Well, this is the man they want on serve, isn't it? Here's Lazo. Yamamoto's got it. Big bonus, that gets Lazo out of there. Well, Takahashi last time he came up at the service position. Sent an ace down. Can he do it again? Just missed. They were ready to raise the roof. Instead, point. Argentina's fifth. Ramos. Now they could have wrapped up this set only to miss. And the chance to seal it here. No! It's sent back. It's not over yet. It's long. It's a set to Argentina. Will they challenge it? Might as well. Might as well. But that looked long. That looked long. So they're not challenging that, they're challenging a block touch. Did this catch anything on the way through? If it did, Argentina will have to go and do it all over again. I'm not sure it did. And there will be an Argentinian player who will know for certain anything there. Need to see this, you'll just need to hear from the reaction of the crowd if that's taken a touch. If it has, it'll be the biggest cheer of the night. Not like much there. No, we're going into a fourth set. Well, 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 how well played, Argentina. They were pushed to the limit. They held out. turn into another set. For the first time, Japan not in a three-setter here. Numbers then, Argentina winning the attack battle, just blocks and serves, not a story. That's a message for Argentina. Very simple. If you can just keep the blocks under control, you got a chance of winning the set. Made heavy weather of it, and now Japan must be ruined. Those three errors in a row that saw that lead just tossed away. This one is not over, not even close to being over. Themselves off the floor. Argentina have to use that to build momentum for this fourth set. The South Americans up and running. Oh, can't find anything there. Lima. Keita. Service receptions are pretty good. Tina must be just grateful to be in this. They don't have anybody in double figure scoring yet. Seven, Ramos with six. There's trouble. They're not only going to do it second time. Just going to back, so this should be a put away. Needs to be a put away. Every time you see anything like that, you know you've got to win the game. You have to. They've got a block up as well, and Ramos and Lazo couldn't keep the teenager out. So Ishikawa, big server. He'll stay at the service line. This should be an easy put away. Maybe get a third time. Can't get away with one. That's a missed opportunity for Argentina. It also gets Lazo out of there. It's a double win for Japan. No business winning that one at all. Here comes another one of the big servers. Nishida. Palacios is really just gobbling them up. Lovely rescue work there by Nishida. What's there? He won't give it in play. Aguera gets the win. That's 2 points in a row. Argentina will be looking at it and saying, we were in these 2 points. Should have had them. If they had claimed them, Japan would be in a world of trouble right now. Instead, they're leading 6-5. And will Nishida continue to go after Palacios? And there's an ace. Vicious serve. That's what you've got to do. Change it up. Hard one for Donani to take. He had no position on that at all. Oh, an ace. There haven't been too many of those for Japan in this match. Come on. was there alongside Onodera, and I think it was the left hand of Onodera that sent that one back. Well, they get an ace, then they get a stop block. That's what worked for them earlier.
When you see that he's playing, he's there. You can confront
say Ishikawa's done really well to get anything on that at all, but look how quickly he got over there. And Ishikawa is able to finish the job, but that block could have dropped in. They won't care how the points come, as long as they do come, though, Japan. They fought for it. And they got Palacios out of there. So Kita.
Thank you.
Got to be a side out. This deep in the set. There's a freebie. So Argentina hanging on here. It's the Ramos serve coming up. Japan surely have got to make hay here. Take away Shikawa. Tatsuya Fukuzawa on his serve. What do we see here? Serve needed just when Argentina had closed to within one. It's getting away again.
Estamos los dos, tenemos que meter, si viene abajo, corto, le damos altura para poder rotar bien. Pensemos la primera bola.
Side out. Argentina Fukuzawa varies the pace. Simply. Doesn't find a winner. There's a chance here for Japan. Runs it off the block. No stopping Japan now, surely. Wonderful defensive work again. Yamamoto getting everything under. Suddenly Argentina are staring down the barrel of a four-point deficit to claw back. With Japan just 6 points from wrapping it up. That's borderline impossible. Fukuzawa stays on. The block is there. Last time up, that sparked that revival from Argentina. Can Ezequiel Palacios do it again here. Lazo can do some more damage. He has three aces. Palacios has handled that one beautifully. They've got underneath it, Sakita. Ishida. Still alive. Still alive. And now Argentina can reset. Lazo, no. Sakita's there again. Ishida. Palacios, brilliant. Lima. Off the block. This is Argentina's last chance. Great shot here. They got the server they wanted. They got the overpass. But then Palacios can't find the cross court. And that's takes us to match point. It is a challenge. Why not? For a net touch. This smacks of desperation here, but why wouldn't you in this situation? It's match point. Marcelo Mendes has got to hope that there's something here. See the back of Nicolas Lazo. It's been picked up. Team effort from Japan. match here, or in last match on this court, we've seen them subside. It's the third defeat in a row. Ahead right now, though, they can close the door on 5 days of drama in Fukuoka. On the right side of the winning line, the victory photo belongs to Japan. And this really was a team effort. Here's the numbers then. Again, when they need it, they get the blocks. The Lazo serve was a beast, it really was. It helped Argentina stay alive at the death there. But Ishikawa was superb today. Nishida, and Fukuzawa, and Onodera all played their part massively as well. Big contribution from Kentaro Takahashi, who certainly justified his